Hello students, now today we will study the new lesson, lesson 5. This is our first class after the first periodical test. So today we will study about the forms and frames, that how we create a form and frames over a web page. So we interact with many forms on the internet every day. You have seen on the internet that the form for the UPSC, Indian Public Service Commission, and the form for the SSC, Staff Selection Commission, and the form for the that is the Advanced JEE IIT and for the NEET. So all that forms which you see like that, when which you have to fill your name and fill your gender, eye color, and your educational qualification and other details, address and other things. So these forms are created with the help of the this form tag in the HTML. And different frames also you have seen. The frames means you can see like here, this window. Here you can see the outer, that is the application bar. Now this is the menu bar, another frame. And here you can see, after that, this is the another frame where you find all this. The buttons are there. Similarly, there is the another frame, you can see where this content is displayed. That is called the frames, where different things can be where different things can be shown. Now whether you are searching for a topic or logging into your email account, you use forms in one or the other way. So when you are logging to your email account, so in the form you are entering your login ID and password, so that is the form. A form can be useful to collect personal information, contact information, opinions, any user input the author may need to enter the shipping or credit card data, to order a product, or to retrieve search results from a search engine, etc. Means whenever you wants to go to create a, that is a Facebook ID, so at that time you have to fill all the details. So where you are filling all the details in a form, so that visual or that platform where you are entering all the details, your name, the profile name, and the other information about educational qualification, your address, all these things. So that platform is the form. And you can you have also seen when you are doing the online shopping and you are entering the details of your credit card or your address details too, that your product, your purchased goods should be delivered at the that address. So where you are filling all these details, that place is called the form. Now see, what is form? A form is a collection of fields. Yes, form is a collection of field. In a form, there are many fields of information on a page. A form is a collection of fields of information on a page, on a particular page. As you can see, these are fields. The name field, and the value, gender field, eye color field, and describe your athletic ability, enter my information, that is the button. So it resembles a paper on which a user fills the required information. So this form is like a paper on which you are giving all the information, filling all the information. The various fields of data in a form may contain text boxes. Yes, so what, this is the text box where you will fill the name. So what are the fields of the data in a form? Text boxes, radio buttons. Yes, this is the radio button, like the male and female. This button is the radio button. Before the male, you are seeing this circular button is the radio button. So the various fields of the data in a form may contain text boxes, radio button, drop down menus. Yes, drop down menus. So many times you see when you click on the drop down menus, like a small triangle button here, like this. This is the drop down menu. When I click on it, you'll find the this menu. This is called the drop down menu. Okay, like here also you find this is panelistic drop down menu. See, many options are available in this, that is called the drop down menu. Now the various fields of data in a form may contain the text boxes, radio buttons, drop down menu, check boxes. Yes, where you can do the check. This is the check boxes, rectangular boxes, the check boxes. Check all that apply. See, over 6 feet tall you are, or over 200 pounds weight. password boxes where you enter the password and the other elements. These elements are called form controls. Yes, all these are called the form controls. The simple HTML codes contain two elements, the form element and the input element. And this nested within the form element. So input element is nested within the form element. So the form nested means inside the input, the form element and input element nested within the form element. Yes, this input element can be nested. Inside a form, you can create another form also. So the form element sets up an area for a form on the web page. Yes, this form elements, when you open the form tag and close the form tag, so that form tag will reserve some area on the web page for a form. Now the input element creates the various form controls. With the help of the input element, we create the different controls on the form. That is the button control, text box control, checkbox control, etc. on the form area, text area control, many radio button control, many controls are there. Okay, now working of forms. Working of forms. Let us see how the forms traverse from the design phase to the execution phase, how we move from the design to the execution. So HTML elements are used within the form elements to create and name the form controls, as well as the format, their appearance and behavior. So these HTML elements are used and within the form element to create the name of the, to create and name the form controls. Yes, so the controls you can give some name, like text box you can give some name, like text box 1, text box 2, text box 3 you can give. Okay, like radio button 1, radio button 2, like you can give the names. So an attribute in the form element tells the browser and web server about the program that will process the form information. Yes, so in the attribute in the form element, yes, form is an element of the HTML. So every element has its attributes, has its some properties, and that properties are called attribute. So this attribute in the form elements tells the browser and the web server about the program that will process the form information. Now the browser displays the form and allows the server to fill it out, collects the data and sends it to the web server. Yes, this browser displays the form and allows the server who is searching to fill out the data, and it collects the data and sends to the web server. So it sends to the server. You can send it to your mail also, all the data. Only you have to specify the address where you want to send. The web server sends the data to the CGI, Common Gateway Interface, that is the program for processing. Now that server will process the data and save it into to their database. Now the CGI program processes the form data, and processed information is sent back to the browser whenever a request will appear to the to the server. Next, this you can see, a web form consists of the two parts, that is the HTML front end and a back end form processor. Yes, with the at the front end we are entering all the details, we submit the form, but at a back end the form will be processed by a processor. The HTML front end part handles the presentation while the back end handles the form submission. Yes, how the form will be submitted, where it will be saved, that is controlled by the back end. The back end of the form is usually written in the language like, yes, so that is the back end of the website is maintained by the language PHP or ASP, preprocessor hypertext, or ASP active server pages. These are the languages that, like the HTML, CSS is the language for front end programming, that is for creating a website. And the website data, how will be processed while submitting, so that is controlled by the back end programming. The person who handles these are called the back end programmers, and these are deal with the language PHP or ASP. CGI, Common Gateway Interface, the programs are required to process the information present in a form. Yes, some program is needed, it is called the CGI, Common Gateway Interface, to process the information present in a form. There are two types of CGI programs and CGI scripts. So the only difference between the two is that CGI programs make use of compiled languages, such as, yes, CGI programs make use of the compiled languages like Visual Basic, C, C++, etc. Whereas the scripts make use of the scripting languages such as Perl, Unix or Shell scripts. Next, now creating a form, how we create a form. So every form uses a form element. So form is created with the help of the form element, see, which is begins with the form tag open and ends with the form tag close. So form is a container element. Form is a container element. It has opening and closing. It has its opening and closing. Every time it gets adjusted. Now, it also includes some unique elements for each control, such as input element, select element, and text area element. So these tags inform the browser that anything specified between them belongs to the form. So whatever the controls are specified inside the form open and close, that belongs to the form element. Okay. So now we see this. Yes. Now see the syntax, how we create a form. HTML open, body open, form open. Now the form elements you write here, form close, body close, and HTML close. So the form should be written inside the body tag. So see, the form is a container tag. It defines the form elements, syntax form open, form close, and between the form open and close you write the form elements used within the tag's body. Form is always used within the body tag. Now forms can be divided into three sections, that is the form header, input field, action buttons. Now to set up a form, you need to specify two important attributes, that is the action and method. Now we'll learn about the action, what is the action and what is the method. Now, action. It specifies that the file or page that the form is submitted to, file or page that is the form submitted to, the values could be a URL to the script or an email address. Means where you want to submit the form details, where you want to submit the form. So the values what you write for the in the action field, in the action attribute, action is an attribute, and the value what you write for the action, that must be a URL, or you can write your email address. So if you write your email address, your form details will be submitted to your mail. And if you write a URL of any base database, so that will be submitted to that database. So either be a URL to the script or an email address defined with the mail to function. Defined with the mail to function that should receive the form information. That you write the mail to and the address. So method, it specifies that the form information should be posted to the URL given in the action attributes. Yes, so method means here where you want to submit it, so that you write the URL in the action attribute and the possible values are get and post. It specifies that the form information should be posted to the URL given in the action attribute only, and the possible values for the method is the get and post. So when you write the get and when you write the post. Now see here, syntax form action. See the here you write the mail address, mail to email ID, method equals to post, and name equals to name of the form. So get, this is the default value. Get, this is the default value. It is used whenever you wish the email, when you wish to email the form contents. So when if you want to send this to the mail, so you use the method get. But if you don't want to see the content, you use the method post. So when we use the get, so we can see the things on the here on the title bar, what the things we have. Means all the form details will be appear on the title bar when you submit it. Post, you can make use of this value whenever you want to pass the information to the URL specified in the action attribute. So that should not appear in the mail. So get we use to email the content, and post is used to pass the information to the database. Means whatever the URL you have specified in the action attribute. Now you can see it here. See the HTML open, head open, title tag open and close, and the title then form one. Now you see this head closed. Now the heading two is open, and the body tag is open, and the background color for the web page is set cyan, and here it is written the sample form in the heading H2. So there is the mistake. This heading you write after this body tag. Okay, this is the mistake here. Okay, this is all for today, students. So remaining portions we will study in the next class. Thank you for your kind attention.